Test, test, test. Great. Okay. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today, we're going to talk about Google Apps. But before this, I'm going to introduce myself. But my name is Marian Ibrahim, and my partner is Arwa Bakir. Since you're discovering what is Google Apps, before that, we need to talk about CamCloud. CamCloud is a company, it's a partner with Google. They sell Google Apps applications, they implement, they migrate, as well as they train, as well as custom development applications with Google Apps Engine for your information, for your technology information at your company. Arwa is going to translate what I'm saying in an Arabic word.
Hello. We have started Google Cloud on the cloud we provide Google Apps in the Middle East. But we have achieved Google Apps and Google application. سواء بالبزنس بالإدوكيشن بالتعليم بكل شيء نحن we provide an open application.
Now since CamCloud started since a year was a business model from the United States, we had a company, a sister company called Vio. We started to implement this kind of business model since the cloud computing technology, which is basically having novel solutions, having a new solution at your company, a cloud computing concept, which is Google Apps is offering for you. And since you're an education program, as well, they offer you for you Google Apps education, as well as business, as well as government, as well as non-profit organizations.
One thing that we keep, our partners are Google in Los Angeles, the US, and they provide the Google application, especially the Google application, especially in education, the timing. كل شيء نحن لتطبيقات موبايل بالتعليم نحن بنقدمها ل هون عندنا بالمملكه العربيه
السعوديه. هيك اكتشفنا في ترانزيت ف على كل حال I'm going to talk in English since I was studying English all my life. Basically, CamCloud, if you, let's say you're at university or a school or any kind of education that your domain name has dot edu, and you heard about Google Apps, and you want to implement this kind of technology. Now, this is an old question, common question I always get. Why should I go to a third company or partner with Google and install the Google Apps? I can do it by myself. Now, since it's a cloud computing technology and it's a new technology, first you need human resources for that. You need the right tools to emigrate the emails that you have at your organization. After this, you need to train your employees, you need to train your students, your admin, to adapt to them to the environment of Google Apps. After this, if your company or your organization or your university has an Active Directory synchronizing or has an application installed inside their university, they want to upload it to Google Apps Engine, we do that for you guys. So we train you, we adapt you to the cloud concept, and what we all need, since the old concept needs networking, needs training, you don't need all that things. The cloud computing concept, we could do that physically, face-to-face, we could do that on webinars, we could even do that on phone calls. It's easy, it's more adaptable for your organization. Now, after this, now also Google Apps, we also look at a couple of things before installing Google Apps at your university. We look at the industry, we look at location, we look at your company culture. Since you're, let's say you're a university that you don't have our English base, so we implement the Google Apps in an Arabic way, have information technology at your language, at your culture. Even let's say your company has a location that's far away from Riyadh, since we're CamCloud located in Saudi Arabia and Riyadh, our headquarters is based in Riyadh, we could also go there, travel there, meet with you face to face, and adapt you to the Google Apps education. The industry, it matters for the business side because, you know, there's a lot of industries. You have the manufacturing, you have the ITs, you have the training, you have a couple of industries. Now, since for education, it's almost the same
thing, so we don't mind of implementing this kind of technology at your organization. After this, what kind of services do we do at the Camel Club? Since Open Apps has a process to implement this kind of technology at your organization, we start by, first of all, the licensing. We provide you the licensing. Now, also, you can go and bring it directly from Google, but we, as our partners, we have a platform for you. As you are an organic, you are an educational part, you need to deal with us. We deal with Google directly. You have a problem, you need the licensing fast. Google is so big, they're so busy, there's a lot of people around the world. That's why they have partners around the world, even in the Middle East. Well, since we are the first company in Saudi Arabia, we're adopting the fully cloud computing technology. We don't have any software solutions, none of that kind of old solutions. We're focusing on the cloud computing concept. After this, with the domain setup, since your organization is .edu.com, what kind of domains do you have? We implement the configuration MX records, MX records hosting, everything on Google Apps. After this, the Google Apps main integration, since you have an email system, an existing before email system, we migrate this kind of emails, any kind of bot, IMAP, Microsoft Exchange, any kind of solution that you have, we will transfer it and migrate it to Google Apps. Okay. After this, since we're becoming a diversified web on the smartphone technology, so you need to configure your Google Apps on your smartphones. I mean, on BlackBerry's iPhone, Android, we need to configure that. Also, we do our remote setups on the phones, we control your phones, we do everything in a professional way, in an organized way. So all your organizations have this technology. They have it on their phones, they have it on their laptops. And since it's a cloud concept, you can access it anywhere, anytime, any place. After this, we also have, if you have a couple of domains online, you have different domains at your organization, we do alliances to your domain. If you want to set up a certain domain, have them directed to one direct domain, we do that for you. As well as we train Google Apps. I train for you Google Apps. It's not a big part like other solutions. It usually takes 2 to 3 months. But most of our experience with dealing with organizations, they usually take 1 month to set up all the organization, and they can also know about Google Apps. After this, the change management. Now, every process in life has a project management has a process. Change management is not what you do for your organization. Since we start with implementation, we start the migration, the training, this needs process at your organization. And you're not installing for 5, 6, or maybe 10 users. You're installing for thousands of users at your organization. You need to process every kind of department at the organization, how you want to organize that information, how to give them the best Google Apps time efficiency at the same time without lacking your existing work or your existing department work. The post-support, now, basically after the implementation, we usually give, during the implementation process or the deployment, we give support for the training, for the migration. After this, let's say your organization would like to have us always with them, they have questions, they want to train more employees, they want to add more people to the Google Apps system, we will be at post-support for you guys. We will be there, we will implement you, we will teach you, we're always there for you. We answer your phones, this is how we're going. We're always answering our phones. Okay, now, since I said, now also Google Apps, Camel Club, sales or implement for you or helps you at your organization, we have applications. We're also partners with third-party companies. They develop applications and integrate it with Google Apps. I'm going to mention a couple of them. Zoho CRM is a very nice customer relationship management application. We saw that licensing. We also implemented those who train as well as Google Apps. It's a web-based application. You don't need to have a software to install it. And it's a very, they have been on Google since 4 years that they're growing. They're becoming a very large Salesforce. They're becoming one of the biggest CRM solutions around the world. Also, we have our sister company. They have built into the technology called the launch one system for your organization. So let's say everyone has a department, everyone has lunch time, or they're so let's say I don't want to award it X student. I want to award it X Y student. So we start looking at things. And yes, what is the blah, blah, blah. So we start confusing ourselves. But that basically takes your system and then you look at that schema system. You basically specify the student that you want to eat. You click on the student, you add that as a description for the order, and then we'll go for your organization. So it's an ordering system for the ordering system of an organization. You also have my matrix. It's a process management project, which your organization would also benefit for the cloud-based concept. At the end, we have also boosted learning. And boosted learning is only for Google Apps training. Since, let's say, you don't want us to train you, we have also applications that I will show you now in a few seconds. And the drop-down menu for applications, Google Apps, will happen. You have it as a YouTube video or their own system video, I'm sorry. So you will understand everything from the Gmail, from the documents, from the calendar, in your language. And any time, you can also turn it on. And it has a fees, one-time fees during the Google Apps licensing installation. Then it's a social CRM. It's one of the new technologies. We're also partners. We're the first partners in the Middle East with them. It's basically having different, you have Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn. You have different contacts, different social networks. You could gather them all in one platform, communicate, generate your leads, organize them without confusing any kind of platform. Google does that for you. At the end, we're located in King Abdulaziz Road in front of Salah al-Din. Our phone number is here, as well as our information info at camel.com. If you need any questions, we'll always answer you. Directly, our team is here to help you, to support you, and guide you to Google Apps or any cloud platform. Now, let's start with Google Apps. Since everyone is watching on Google Apps, can you please go to the Gmail interface? Google Apps, basically, the concept of Google Apps, how Google created Google Apps. It was first the Gmail concept with the calendar. So then they started to increase this kind of knowledge about, let's say, what is the most important thing that you need in your organization? It's your email system. Your email system is linked to everything. So they started adding the documents, they started adding the groups, the sites, every kind of aspect that your organization needs. Now we have Google Plus, we have Hangouts, we have everything linked without installing any software, without buying an email system. Then you want a document management, then you want a hosting voice system. All these kind of solutions, Google Apps came here, one package solution. Now since right now we're talking about education, what could I benefit from my student? I mean, let's say I'm a student, I'm a teacher, and my students are in my class, I want to control them. And since it's an internet world, our direction, our technology is going to the communication, collaboration. We need to access anytime, anywhere, how can we communicate together? So we started with the Gmail. If we start with the Gmail, can you just minimize it, please? Now, before we go to the Gmail, there is everyone knows the Chromebook. The Chromebook is an operating system for Google. They have also created something called Chromebooks for Samsung. I have a sample over here. This mini laptop, if you look and see, and you could also show up for it. This is only run by Google, a Chromebook. So you don't need to install any kind of Windows, no antiviruses. You don't need to bother yourself with, let's say, I need to update the system, or should I know what happens, or losing my data. Even if this breaks down, I have my data, everything on the cloud. I can access it on my phone, on another laptop. If you can see my browser open up, I have the tabs that I save for my links where I go to this kind of websites. So if I open this in another account, another browser, it will open for me. Can you press Control D, please, so I can open it? I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to open a new tab so I can show you what is my desktop in the background. So this one, basically, also, since everyone is wondering the computing process, can I control my people? Can I have them? Am I house not like everyone is by himself? Yes, you could control your Chromebooks from your admin tool, from your domain setup, and also I'm going to show you. You could control the users, let them access, cut off the data, let them have a couple of things, so you control everything from your dashboard. So let's say this is my desktop. I have access to my Gmail offline.
by also a shortcut to my Gmail event will get bugs pregnant access. This is my desktop, this is on the Chromebook. I need to have a desktop to install or download things. I don't have to think of the cloud based. So if I go to the Gmail now, restart. Just gonna go to the first one, the first tab. Yes, this is the Gmail, but not everyone, like all students, they mostly know the Gmail. Now you can customize your domain to the Gmail. If you notice what we put there, phi@gmail.com. So I'm not at Gmail, I'm not at Google, I'm at my organization. But I'm using Gmail interface. I have 25 gigabytes per user. I could upload 2 gigabytes files, GPA, any kind of file, even Word, the PowerPoint, Excel. We can also talk about that stuff. But since I'm going to show you a couple of features on the Gmail, which is very nice. If you go down the chat, you have the chat room, you have the SMS. You can send SMS any folder, any kind of folder around the world for free. You have 50 SMS for free. You can see your I can see my friends, my colleagues, at any time they're online. I can know if they're on Android device or not. Although I can also communicate right now. I could chat with them. So this is basically for a student concept. He has his email. This is the core of his solution. Then he starts sending his SMS, chatting with his friends, sending emails. He could customize his Gmail. He could add features on his Gmail. If he press on the compose, can you please press on the compose button? Down. Red box compose. Can you go back to the calendar? Go back to the, so I'm so sorry, because we don't have the control from here. Go back to that email. I could know a personal profile by if he exists or not. Yes, or press on the compose. Then let's say I have, if you see on the right side, this is the information that I'm sending. Let's say I want to send to, can you press please? Can you type on the two command? Let's say command K, just press K. Oh, down, yes, on two, press K. Type K, please. So, okay, enter. If you see over here, it will synchronize, it will look for your data. So let's say, command has a LinkedIn account. He also has a Twitter. So I can know a profile of a person. And guess what? This is not a good experiment. This is third-party companies, they build applications integrated to the Gmail. And guess what? Every day they're developing new things on the Gmail. You're not committed to a software to update it. It's a web-based solution. So it updates by itself. Google has also a product that you can do. What is the new things that Google has? You can follow up with the Gmail. It's a very simple, you can have your customized, and you don't worry for sending a password, it's bigger than for 3,000 mega, or you always receive on the Gmail. It's a very well-known email base. You always access it anywhere, anytime. You could customize your email. I could log in through gmail.com, I could log in through chemical.email.chemical.com. I have my features from my organization. If we leave the Gmail, then if you see about on the tab, you have the social, you have command desk, you have email, calendar, documents, sites, groups, and more. These are the packages that Google Apps will give you. So let's say a student wants to set up a calendar date. You can go to the calendar, set up any type calendar, invite the people to the calendar, you could modify it, share this kind of time. It's very easy. You could make it as a weekly base, monthly base. It's not complicated. You could set the defaults any kind of language you want. After the calendar, you see if you press on documents. Can you please go on documents? Next to calendar, not now. Yes, not documents, yes. The document is our desktop for the files, for everything I save. So let's say I want to create the folder. If you see all these colors, you have the Google Doc folder to create. Now, can you go down, please? Excuse me. I thought it was terrible. If you see
document. Look at us as a very good collaboration tool. So let's say, me and my friend, okay, my classmate, we have a project to do. So let's say, I want to create a document. If you go up a little bit. Yes, can you go up a little bit and see? No, progress on this place. Just go up. Okay, press on this one, press on this one, exactly. Yes, press on this one, then. Okay, so let's take one piece out. I create the document. Okay, forget about this. Can you go on the create down piece? On the create part? Not before, okay. For create. Okay, press on create. Press on document. Look at this box set. So we press on document, press on document. I'm gonna create a document. I want to do anything. And you tap it open for me. You will see. You can hear the first because I want to finish it. Can you refresh it, please? This is not it. Everyone was asking me last time on the stand. But let's say I have an estate as well, but I have Adobe, you know, Adobe has a big, very big fund to install at your computer. So what should I do? I mean, it's a very nice question. I mean, usually, since Google started this cloud computing concept, they're going to the cloud direction. You don't need to install anything on your desktop. All that kind of, let's say, Adobe, they would create a cloud solution. So, they will integrate it on the other browser, so you can also create a file on Adobe or PDF, whatever, and you can work on it with the next one. I think if you know everyone is, they're talking about the cloud, where's the cloud? So they're creating platforms for the cloud as a service for you guys. I mean, what are these? You're what? You're an education, you're a teacher. Okay, fine, you're a big university. Why should I be an IT? Why should I spend thousands of dollars, maybe millions of dollars, spending a solution that maybe in 2 years that no one will learn it, I'm gonna throw it there. It's just a problem. But this is a platform, a concept, as a software as a service. We create a platform for you. You will get it as an interface, very easy, very simple. Then we upgrade it, we take care of it, and then comes out the privacy. Oh my god, my dad hasn't a cloud, what should I do? Well, what do I do? First of all, I know that Google has spent 15 years, they're the internet leaders. They started in the garage, and then they became Google by the reputation. So they created the concept of IT. So now you're outsourcing your IT. You're focusing on your business. You're focusing on your education. So they take care of the selling. They would create things. I mean, we also create, we're partners with Google. We construct the offer for you guys. Or you could benefit for the students, you could benefit for the business plan. This is the cloud concept. Everything is about communication, collaboration. I mean, maybe guess what? Maybe tomorrow I will have the data file with me. I don't know. Maybe not. Maybe I will download my device. Who knows? But this is the cloud that we're going to. This is where we're heading. So as a student, I mean, statistically, I personally, I stayed almost 15 hours a day on the internet. Everyone asks me, okay, is the network connection? But guess what? Our country, we have the best. Zion has the best internet. It's going to have a central connection. We have the fiber optics. Everything. I mean, if you are in an organization, if you have the desktop, if you don't have it, you're not going to do anything. Maybe you're going to use an image for the network. But guess what? You're going to know how to access the supply material. You need to have internet. This is our concept. Internet is the battery for our lives. So, if you go back now, I created the document. Creating a document, so let's see. Share with me, Anna, please. If you go up here on the sharing point, now the document is almost like Word document. But we also have our own futures, we are developing our new futures. So I share, let's see, let's share with Obelix. Now I created the document. I could set my default settings. Now by default, you're private.
So only when this document will be accessed by the one that you're giving him, then add it. That's it. So I add it to my own. I'm going to show you the I could also change this account I've set up. I could make it as a link. If you press on the change button on the place below, press on the change. Now, you could all click. Anyone can view this one? Anyone with a link? You set up any kind of content that you want. So let's say he's a teacher and has an assignment with another university, or he has a research that kind of university are not users at this organization. So I'm going to click the link, copy paste it, and send it to him. Very simple. And since it's a web page, I just click on the link, it will open directly to the docs for me. So I can type with him. So let's say I type it out. Now, I have said he invited me here. I'm going to have my Chromebook. It's TG1.1. So I get an invitation from my brother, TK, a document, and he wants me to show with him. So I open this doc. Open title. Now, if you notice here, there is one viewer. And it's my back. So, command is there. Now, where is the other guy? Now, if I go back to the document, hello for my one. I press hello one command. You can see that I'm typing with arrow at the same time. You could know that arrow is there. Imagine this for a student. I don't know, because I'm going to start talking and I'm going to start talking. But as soon as I feel me and I'm more communicating to my left, yeah, I'm going to switch this over. Let's get over it. So let's say I'm at my friend's house. I don't have my laptop. I have my phone. I have my iPad. I have my Android. What kind of device? I have a tablet that I want to use. I can access that tablet, open the link, or open the share I open with them, and do my homework. Simple, easy, fast. Let's go sleep. Let's go do whatever I want. I could chat with him also. Let's say we have a project to do. Let's do it now. What are your ideas? Let's add 100 users in this new document at the same time. We all have covers, they all have, so I can type your users inside there. I could type anytime I want. I could also command. So if I shout out, please. Hello, shout out. Let's say shout out. Hello from Anna. Okay. Go to insert. Insert. Oh, insert. Okay. Insert a comment. Insert. Okay. Well, yes, yes. Go down. Comment. Little bit down, 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 up, up. Check out what is that one was. Press a comment. So, you can see here, I have a comment, so I like this document, right? Not. I left something comment for Arrow to leave an item. I also could invite another people from the comment side. They would get their Gmail. They could add it from their Gmail as well. So I'm not committed to this document. I could access it anywhere. Even I could add it from my Gmail. Now, if you go back to the desktop of the document, please. The document, I could decide, let's say, I don't have, even though I could access it by Safari, by Firefox, or even by Explorer, I could access it anytime. As soon as you have your browser, you have an internet connection, you could access this file. So let's say, this is my desktop. I'm going to download this file that I created now. If I click on it, I want to download it as a Microsoft Word document. You have the option to do that. You want to download it as a PDF, you can download it. You have any kind of file. You want to download any kind of file. Concerning that kind of document, so if I press on it, if you do, please on the right, press on this document. No, press on the square. Yes, yes, back up. Anyways, so if we go. If we go from the desktop, you could upload 2K, as I said. You have any kind of file, you could convert your file that you want. So let's say I want to upload the Microsoft Word document. I want to make it a Google Doc. So they will ask you if I press on the upload button, please. Yes. changes. First, under appropriate spacing, beside the plate now. Okay, forget about the documents. Let's go to the other part of applications. Now, everyone was asking me, why do we call this login apps? Well, this is a very nice question. Login apps, first of all, I told you about the package. You have slides, groups, you have part of documents, calendar, as well as Gmail. Now, if you go to the drop-down menu more, you're going to find applications that you added from the Google Enterprise Marketplace. So let's say you're a teacher, you go to, let's say going to Android Marketplace, you find the best application that you like it, and you add it on your phone. So also Google did create a marketplace for your organization. Third-party companies are developing applications, uploading them, or making them integrated with Google Apps, and you could benefit as well. There's some of them are for free as well as a paid version. You could find any kind of place. So let's go, if you see here the drop-down menu, I have all the applications that I usually use in my organization. From the CRM, ERP, class, every kind of application that you need at your classroom, at your organization, you could benefit from. So if you're going to find more services, These applications, if I press on them, it will directly open a new tab, log in to Zoho CRM. I will have my file open there for invoice or for CRM. Directly, I don't need to install the username or password. Since I'm logged in from the first time to the Gmail, that's a verification password that I have to ask me for. So I don't need to log in again and again. So if I press on Find More Services, then one more. No, not this one. I need to show you, this is very nice and interesting, and you can find any setting you want. Do you want productivity, do you want an application, do you want any financial and accounting, any kind of thing that you want at your organization, you will find it. So if you go on the email, yes, a little bit, press on this one, yes, go to the board, find more services, go down. Okay, a new tab will open for you. You will be able to download and direct into the Google Marketplace. This is the Google Marketplace interface. You will see that you can find professional services like us, partners on Google. You want a diploma and direct, you want to find the ratings of that. So let's say if you can see here, there is admin tools, there is accounting and finance, any kind of thing that you want. So let's go to the education. If you go to that edition, even you have that interface that will show you the latest new applications that are on the marketplace, the ratings of them, the vendors, who are they, what are the details about them. So let's see, we go to IDU, Google Apps, down, last one, yes, that's on IDU, no, down. Okay, let's say we want to workflows. Yes. So let's say these are the applications. If I put the mouse on audio, put the mouse on the first one, please. You can see that they have 13, they have 4 stars. That's a description of them. If I press on it, yes, please press on it. Now this is the only thing that you will get. You know, if you have a Gmail account, you won't have this access to the Google Marketplace. That's why this is the Google Apps description. So once you have a Google Apps licensing, you will have a control for the Google Apps Marketplace, as well as you're going to have a dashboard or control panel for your organization to control your users and features that you want through the platform Google Apps. So let's say if you press on, please,
Even though if you have problems with this kind of applications, you could go back into Google. They will help you. Since they're inside Google's world of applications, so they're secured by Google. There's no bugs to know. Thank God. So we usually don't face problems with this kind of applications. So if you see here, you could have the description of Google Apps. You have the vendor. You have the ratings of them. You could also know that if they're in Gmail, if they're in Twitter, and Facebook. It depends on the company that they're developing this kind of application. Even if you have a problem, you could also report your product policy to them, so you could access them. Have everything on this. You also have their communications. Let's say you want to know who's the vendor, where is he located. You have all the instructions for that. So if we go back to the Gmail, please. How could I control my organization? Now, not everyone would have this kind of future, because you as a CIO or an IT manager would have the control for your information to monitor your organization. So if you go to settings, on the right side, yes. Now, down, the one below, press on this. Now, if you see here, manage this domain. If you go here, this one, you would add it, if you're an IT or a teacher, that the IT gave you the access to control this domain. If you press on this, please, they would back, you would have your control panel. So, but when you, a new open tab will open for you, you need to verify the account, of course, since, I don't know, doesn't know my password. Sign in as a different account if you want. The control panel basically, as a teacher, I don't want the students to have access for their contacts, let's say. So I could turn off or on this kind of feature for my students. Let's say I don't want my students to have, let's say I created groups for my students, and I want this group to have this kind of application. This group, I want them to have the documents. So I could limit any kind of features if I have the control panel, of course, the control panel features. So now, if you log into the control panel, you could find, first of all, the licensings, if you expire it, if you have problems with the third-party companies and applications, you need to renew your licensing, you have problems with your domain, everything will explain to you in this control panel. And this is also we're going to explain later about Google Hangouts. Google Hangouts, if you know about Google Plus is also a social network for Google. It's integrated with Google Apps. So let's say you could have your profile, you could create your circles as a student, as a professor, as any kind of type of circles, and have them linked together, have a voice and video conference, have a shared document at the same time. It's amazing. Okay, let's leave now the control panel. If you go to your Gmail here, we'll show you the Google Docs. Google Docs. Now, this is my profile. I have Google Docs with my package. If I press on Start Hangout, I could create a video, share the video as well, share my screen, have them circles. I identify my circles, my people that I want them to share this kind of video. So let's say, I was logged in as an account on that one. He wants me to invite. We have one hard chat room. We also have, as I explained before, you have the chat room in your Gmail. You could also have Google Talk. You could also have SMS and video. But this is more as an advanced one. So let's say, if I don't get you, and I want you to help me, please add for me. If you go, advanced features, no extra features, please. You press on that. You will ask you, the extra features is having a share screen, having a document site. So let's press on try, please. might speak to Adam. So let's see. If it will happen for you. Now, this is your own issues. We have to communicate with our partners, with Google, with Vio, with Zoom. So we don't have a software. We don't have a system that we pay hundreds of thousands to install it. We have Google Hangouts. It's very easy, very simple. Let's see, you can have me. He's happy. Under that, below, let's press here. Type in my name. You see, if you can notice here, you have the circles. So, Allah has been my circle. Now, you press on command. Press on start this hangout. As soon as I'm logged in here, something will ring. Allah is calling you. So, you can notice now. You have opened the documents. Now the gate is going to open. The slides, the drawings. You can share the documents that you open. Now since Allah is calling me, you have to press. You have a notification on your desktop for the Gmail. If you press on it, now Allah also could share a document as a video file. You could press on OK, open. Email address. Yeah. Okay. They're going to ask me to join this hangout. I'm going to join with them. We're joining now. If you can see me in a couple of seconds. Now, if you can see up here, you can share the screen. They usually ask me, why there's no feature of sharing screens like Skype, for example. No, there is. They have Skype. We have invite, also you can share the document at the same time. So let's say, share with me a document. We start a document by pressing on the document, giving I can share the drawing. Share a document, the notes. This is also very nice. You can share the drawing at the same time. I'm sharing with you the drawing as well. So if you notice here, also, you could change the settings that you want when I make it. You have the settings features, you can access it. It's a very simple one. You have the camera type, by default, your mic, everything settings that you want to use them. So let's say now, since I'm just going to say, no, you can grab one. I'm going to take that. Okay, but I understand this concept. I have to take that from you, gentlemen, and let me. So, I'm sharing everything in a web-based server. I don't need the software to install. I don't have problems in facing that. All I need is, we'll try again, because that web connection is slow to a deep one. Let's try again, please. After this, this is what we try in Google for education. Now, I haven't mentioned this. Google Apps for Education, the licensing is for free. We don't charge for you $50 per user. We charge for the business side, for that, for the, also for the government as well. But we don't charge at the licensing for education. Now, what is the benefit for Google? There's no benefit, to be honest with you. We can sell it when their university, when in Stanford helped them. They developed the user tools for Stanford, so they started the education part. So that's why they feel that giving education is something free, because there is no schools, there is no education is in the internet. I'll search on the Google Apps, yes. So, this is a concept in Google Apps for education. It's easy, the students will love it. You can access it anytime in your access for an internet dynamo, so you can have it. Any time, any more, any please. Any questions, please? Yes? Right.
less than you could be in half cylinders. And the cylinders will be created. And I have a setting the cover on the left of the dials with fire. The part of the machine is fully restarted, but not doing fire yet. I mean, we have to have the equipment that will probably have as a model. Like in the model, if you get to myself to both Microsoft, Microsoft, on the old one, I said, so my fee can really, the camera, one way is that it's clear. The camera will be Microsoft model. The camera will be a man, like as an annual model, and then we'll upload the dance in the day, we'll learn the world. Shukran. Thank you very much. My Microsoft, then it's not a dynamo, Microsoft Word, Microsoft Word, Google Docs, I think. But,
any other questions?
I'm sorry, I'm going to speak in English because sometimes I don't know their translation to Arabic. I'm wondering when Memphis is going to have some applications and programs for specialties such as medicine and engineering. Yes, we do have opportunities for general use and for professions, but for professional use, probably we already don't have some programs that would be very helpful for these specialties. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Basically, I mean, it's a very big open marketplace. I mean, let's say there's a small deal, you need to have a development team to create an application for your domain. But let me tell you, this is very nice. Google has an open platform. You could, if you have a software application, and if you have a software application running, you would train it by your company or yourself, you could benefit from Google's engine, Google Apps engine. So let's say, you upload them to the Google Apps engine. They have PHP code, they have JavaScript, they have Python. Any kind of language that's integrated with Google Apps, you can upload it, they will take care of running it, matching that, everything, and you'll have the variety of accessing as a cloud platform. Now, I could, if you could, you could go to the slide, I could give you the links to the code data, I could give you to how you could benefit from Google Apps in general, Google Apps API. I will help you out for developing one or using Google's platform with your existing application. Any questions?
Well, my question is very simple. I already have a Gmail account. So will I find these features?
Okay. The simple features that you're getting on the Gmail is basically the Google Sites, Google Documents, Google Calendar, and even also Google Plus. But the Google Apps marketplace, you won't have it. You will have more features on the Google Docs uploading and more capacity. You will have the control panel. You will have more access for on the administration part. And Gmail is a simple interface part that you will have the documents, sites, you use them for your personal use. But for Google Apps, it's a more detailed feature of the interface. Any other questions? Thank you very much, gentlemen. السلام عليكم. نتوقف عند الفقرة الأخيرة. بعد الصلاة سيكون معنا التعليم بين الفن والتطبيقات من شابي حسن شركة فلايت شيب مطور